In this video, we will show you how to perform an axillary vein puncture. Today, most cardiologists choose one of two approaches. The classic approach is the cephalic vein cutdown. It has a very low complication rate, but it requires significant surgical skills and is considered more time-consuming. Therefore, most cardiologists prefer subclavian puncture, which is unfortunately associated with pneumothorax and subclavian crush syndrome. Axillary vein puncture is gaining popularity as these complications are largely avoided. After reaching the pectoral fascia, we move the fluoroscopy tube to a very caudal angle. The area of interest is a triangle defined by the clavicle and the first rib. As we can clearly see the edge of the rib cage, there is no risk of pneumothorax. After venous blood return into the syringe, we can now advance the guide wire. Be careful not to advance the guide wire into the jugular vein, but rather downwards to the superior caval vein. Appreciate also how the puncture has at least a 30 degree angle as compared to the skin, typical for axillary vein punctures. When additional leads need to be placed, we can use the existing guide wire to guide the second or third puncture. The guide wire should advance easily into the venous system. Before advancing the introducer over the guide wire, we need to make sure that we have not punctured the artery. By moving the fluoroscopy tube over the heart in anteroposterior position, we can check whether the guide wires are in the right atrium. The benefits of this approach is that it's relatively fast and no surgical skills are required. And we can avoid complications such as pneumothorax and subclavian crush syndrome.